Hey everybody, this is Pete Ciccone from MANSports. Today is Thursday, January 20th. We're 27 and a half weeks out from the USA's. It's chest day, so we're gonna go have some fun. Got my training partner, got my body octane, and we're ready to go. Check it out.
Let's go, guys.
Let's do it. Derek killing it again here in World Gym San Diego at 619 Muscle. We just finished a ball busting chest session. It was really funny. We started with incline dumbbell press. We did two heavy movements total, but today what we did was a little bit different for the sake of the video, and also a little bit of what we are starting to do as our training evolves. The first movement we did with the incline press, as you'll see, involved a little bit more deep range of motion, a little bit more stretching, so that way we can make sure we're hitting all of the muscle fibers. We did go heavy, but maybe not as heavy as you've seen some people go, but it's all about focus, it's all about squeeze, staying injury free, staying healthy, and putting maximum amount of blood into the muscles. So you get to see that on the video as well.
So when you're doing the incline dumbbells, you saw us rotate the dumbbells. Pete and I have been training for so many years and both have strong chests. We've been able to put up to 140s, whatever, but as you get heavier, you start to jerk the weight, momentum. So with the twist, you lose momentum. You really put more stress on the upper pectoral, less on the delts. It does knock your weight down, but again, you want to stress more quality muscle, not just pushing the muscle. So we use that. We go into it. You get a better rotation, constant tension on the muscle. That's what we're looking for in this whole workout, was based on keeping the tension on the muscle, build a rounder, more 3D look on the chest rather than just build up.
Yeah, as Eric was talking about, with the rotation that we do, we do a little bit better stretch. Something takes a shoulder out of the movement a little bit, puts a little more focus in the stretch and the deep part of this movement. So even though we're going a little bit lighter, it makes it a little bit more challenging to focus on the chest. And like I said, take the front delt out of it a little bit so it protects your shoulders. Real good squeeze, real good arch. So we'll get a little bit more elongation out of the bottom part of the movement. Make this really effective chest builder. All right, makes it heavy though. My last one. Probably 60.
I'll stay tight.
Yep, no worries. Good stretch.
Yep. Good contraction. Come on, squeeze. Yep. Feels easy.
Well, I know for sure doing that, being a little bit more focused, chest has always been a strong point, like Derek had said, for both him and I. So we're doing things a little bit different, not just pushing crazy amounts of weight, but pushing heavy weights with good strict form and really, really paying attention to the feel. I've had a little bit of shoulder issues, not a big deal, but a little bit. Derek, luckily, has been a little bit smarter than me, and he gets a little bit more maintenance than I do, but I'm working on it in terms of maintenance, and staying active all year long is really what's going to end up with a better result. The second movement we did was the flex flat press. And sometimes we'll do flat dumbbells or sometimes we'll do flat barbell press. It really kind of depends on where we're going with it. But we're focusing on upper chest first, hence the incline movement first. But what we wanted to do is we wanted to put some good heavy pounds on the chest. So we did movements in the 6 to 8 rep range for the heavy flex flat press movement, which really hits the pec major. And so we did get our heavy work in. Although we started with a heavy movement with the incline press, we really moved over to the flex and we banged out some good heavy sets there. And then we moved on to our next exercise. Ready, man? One, two, three. Oh, yeah. The next exercise was incline bench press. Thanks. And I'll let Derek tell you a little bit about that one.
So we moved on to incline bench. This is what I call, you've seen the magazines over the years, like upper specialization, lower. So when we went to the upper chest, it wasn't so much to do an extra incline movement. What it's to do is to hit upper chest in a way we don't hit usually. You know, stepping outside the box, doing something that new that'll stimulate muscle, because we've done incline bench for 20 years. We've done incline dumbbells for 20 years. So hitting it from a different perspective, you've seen 21s with biceps, you know, low, high, full. It was to get you to learn to feel the muscle in all the different targets. So with the one and a half, which we do, I do them on legs, on like say hack squats or something, to stimulate different growth or different actions. The one and a half will stimulate more the lower portion of the chest and teach you to like contract the muscle from the beginning.
We do one and a half here too, because it keeps a little bit more time under tension at the bottom half of the movement. So it's our third exercise now. We did two real fun, real heavy ones. So now we get a little bit more strict, a little bit more time under tension, hit different muscle fiber types. Again, with an incline press, so we're hitting the upper part of the chest, but we're starting to get a little bit deeper now because the fatigue is getting more intense. So having some fun, still keeping the pace pretty fast. About 90 seconds of rest in between sets, maximum. So we're lifting heavy, just enough time to rest, but we're still keeping that pace really aggressive.
The upper part we did the upper half to the full, because again, not many people lock out that upper chest. It's to stimulate different growth in different areas. So it's a specialization move from that we come up with just because trial and error to see what works and what doesn't. So as you said, again, the whole workout's being based on new ideas, different concepts, but still keeping the weight heavy, but within range of using the chest and the muscles that we're touching.
One more, just do it.
Halfway up. Explode. Good. That was a better one.
Next, we moved on to the decline hammer press, and we talked about that a little bit during the course of our training. But with the decline hammer, we rotated our hand grip a little bit, some ideas that Derek had picked up from Vince Guaranda back in the old days, doing some a dip movement, but we modified the dip and kept it on the hammer press, a hammer dip machine, so that way we could be a little bit more safe, a little bit more stable, really making sure to keep the health of the shoulders intact while we're stimulating the lower part of the chest and the middle part of the chest as well. Now, that was a really fun movement for me. It took me a while, to be honest with you, to feel that that one, because like I said, you're using a little bit more body weight leaning against the machine rather than direct resistance stimulation on the muscle fibers. Lastly, what we did was, I'm working with Hani Rambar, the procreator. I've been lucky enough to work with him on my last prep last year for the USA, and he got me into the best shape I've ever been, and I want to thank him for that. And one of the things that he's advised me and that we've incorporated into our program that we often do is his FST7 technique, which if any of you are not familiar with it, you got to try it. It's a killer intensifying technique that you can position the FST7 sets at different portions of the workout depending on how you want to do it. And what Derek and I have done in this workout that you'll see is we've used the fly press machine to really just blow up, to flood the muscle with the FST7 principle on the inside part, in the inside middle part of the chest, using the fly motion. And you'll see that, but really basically the FST7 principle involves 7 sets, 15 reps, 30 seconds of rest in between each. It's a very intense movement to flood, to engorge, to bring as much blood as possible into the muscle fibers, stretching that fascia, stretching the muscle tissue for maximum pump and maximum growth stimulation. And lastly, both Derek and I have been lucky enough this year to work with a couple really good supplement sponsors. I want to thank MANSports specifically for supporting me through my quest here in 2011 as I get ready for the USA's. I got real close last year working with Hani and using MANSports' great products. And this year, I hope to get even closer to achieving my personal goals at the USA's this year in July. I've got 28 weeks to go. I've been working really hard. MANSports has been on my side the whole time, so I want to thank them as well. And thank my good buddy Derek and, of course, my wife, Marie Zenz.